in this video, I will specifically talk about rate constants. Why? Because they are important. In previous videos, I talked about the concept of state-to-state dynamics and explained how a system, while entering state, minimizes to get to the bottom of it and spends some time there, unless it has acquired enough energy to make a jump across the energy barrier and enter a different state. As the system spends long time here acquiring energy to move to the next state, it forgets its history and how it got here. So, system's probability to escape to a neighboring basin depends on the rate constants that characterize that probability. These rate constants are independent of what state of the system preceded present state. As for these rate constants, they are purely property of the shape of the potential basin of state I, then the shape of the ridge top that is connecting the current state I to its neighboring state, and then the shape of the next potential basin of the neighboring state. As the transition from state I to the next depends only on rate constants, we can design a simple procedure to propagate the system correctly from state I to J if we know the rate constants correctly for every event. Let us consider there are only two states, A and B, which are connected by a barrier associated with the rate constants. KAB and KBA are the rate constants for forward and backward transition of the system. As rate constants for this hop from system A to B is KAB, second inverse, one may think that the average time that it will have passed until this hop occurs is delta TAB equals to KAB inverse. So one may assume that in a KMC algorithm, after each transition from state A to state B, time would have increased by delta TAB given here. But this is not correct. While a system is in state A each time, it has the same probability of finding an escape path as it had in a previous increment of time. This gives rise to a first order process with exponential decay statistics. The probability of survival given here is the probability that the system has not escaped from state A at time t. The KAB here is the rate of escape from the system A to B. Our interest lies in probability distribution function Pt for the first time of escape. That is, we are interested in determining the probability of first escape of the system. Let time of escape be t dash, then the probability that the system has escaped by time t dash is equal to the 1 minus the probability of system staying in the state A. Thus, we can take the negative of the time derivative of p survival to get the probability distribution function for the time of first escape, as shown here. This gives us the probability distribution for the time of first escape from state A. Pt equals to KAB, exponential of negative KAB and time t. We use this passage time distribution to get the time of escape as integral of probability distribution and get TAB, which is the average time of escape, equals to 1 by KAB. Please note that this TAB is the average time of escape for each time the system is in state A. We need to approximate delta TAB based on random selection from this distribution. For this, we choose a random number R between 0 and 1. This gives us delta TAB, the approximate time of escape from state A to B, as minus 1 by rate constant KAB into ln R. So first, we got the distribution of average time of escape, and then out of that distribution, we picked out randomly a time span which system will take to make one jump from state A to state B in the present hopping event. Now let's move a step further towards the case where at each step of KMC trajectory, multitude of processes are happening from state A to state B. That means multiple pathways are possible. In that case, for each pathway, we determine the probability distribution and then probability of the time of first escape from state A through any of the process A to B is defined. So P escape here is the probability of escape of system from state A. You will notice that the rate constant KAB is replaced by KTOT, that is k total. So this rate constant is the sum of all visual elementary rate constants. I will share a link to a paper explaining this theory in the description section below. Next, we will focus on how to determine these rates post writing a KMC algorithm. As we discussed in our previous video, before starting a Monte Carlo loop, we need to tabulate a list of all possible events and their rate constants. Now, one can use transition state theory to compute the rate constants for each pathway. TST is a good method for solid state diffusive events. TST is pretty straightforward and defines rate constants for escape from state I to state J as the equilibrium flux through a dividing surface separating the two states. To better visualize this, consider a large number of systems in the two state system. Each of it is allowed to transition between these two states independently. If we count the number of forward crossing systems of the dividing surface per unit time, you will see here that only 4 systems crossed to state J in a unit time when t is equal to 1. We divide this number by the number of trajectories and then we will get a rate constant k TST. Now, there are many implicit assumptions associated with TST. TST provides a simple expression for rate constants, but in the most KMCs, harmonic approximation of TST is applied, which is also referred to as Wynyard theory. I have previously given a brief description to this in my video on how to choose a method to study atomistic diffusion. I will also share that link in the description section below. Now, harmonic transition rate theory is characterized by 2 main informations. First, a saddle point, which is the top of the energy barrier and is also referred to as a ridge top. And the next, the energy basin minimum. The saddle plane is a dividing surface that separates the energy basins. With this, the rate constant is derived, given here by K HTST. Here, E static is energy barrier or saddle point, and the prefactor consists of vibrational frequencies in the direction of movement and usually lie in the range of 10 to the power 12 to 10 to the power 13 second inverse. Now we know the theory of rate constants and how to determine them. What next? We still need to figure out the lowest energy saddle point and the energy basins for rate constant calculations using TST. Now, between the two energy basins here, we can have multiple saddle points. Task lay in finding the minimum energy saddle point and potential energy surface. For this transition state search, one must be well equipped with first principle methodology and tools. The most accurate way to do these calculations is by the means of DFT, density functional theory, and there are many softwares available to apply DFT on different type of systems. So using DFT, one can search for transition state by the means of interpolation methods, local methods, or the scaling methods. I will discuss these 3 methods briefly. To start with interpolation methods, such methods are best used when initial and final states are predetermined. The most popular method is nudge-elastic band, NEB. Here, the minimum energy path between the given initial and final states is determined in DFT. Several images in between the two states are assumed and relaxed by 2 forces, a true force from the potential and a virtual spring force. I've already discussed this method before, and there you will find all the potential drawbacks of applying this technique. For more adaptive process where the next state is not known, it is not predefined, and one may need to blindly explore the possible and the most probable escape paths, local methods are preferred. One popular method is dimer method, which allows user to search for a saddle point nearby. Here, 2 identical images of the system with a constant distance between them are considered. Perpendicular to the dimer axis, the system is relaxed along the force. In the dimer axis, the system is relaxed against the force.
The force acting on the center of the dimer gets modified and inverts the component, leading to the minimization of forces that drives the dimer towards the saddle point. Now, all these methods can be computationally expensive, and scaling methods offer a cheaper alternative to find energy barrier. The BEP relation that is shown here is a prominent approach in scaling method, which results in a linear relationship of a kind. Here, EFS and EIS are total energies of final and initial states, and C1 and C2 are constants. By optimizing different nearby geometries, C1 and C2 can be obtained by linear fitting. This was about rate constants. Hope you like this video. If you want to learn KMC from basics, check out my playlist on KMC. If you want to check out MATLAB code for basic KMC algorithm for beginners, you can click on this link. I'll be posting next about boundary conditions in KMC simulation. This will be on suggestion. So if you want to follow up with my updates, please subscribe and press the notification icon. Thank you.